Thank you. right, left, right, left. More time, more. Heart rate, hold. About, hey. Present, hold.
Thank you. devote their time, their talent, their voices, blood, sweat, and tears to make Mississippi Valley State not only look good, but sound amazing as well. And so they're every time we ask for them, they're always there. So thank you again for that. Next on the program, we're going to have The Occasion by Miss Ronnie Williams, Miss Mississippi Valley State University, 2021-2022.
A thousand-mile journey begins with a single step, Lao. Greetings. I am Ronnie Lachey Williams, a criminal justice scholar hailing from the beautifully made Memphis, Tennessee, and I humbly serve as your 69th Miss Mississippi Valley State University for the 2021-2022 academic year. Again, I say, a thousand-mile journey begins with a single step, Lao. Today, I am honored to greet you all and discuss the purpose of today's occasion. Today's occasion focuses on Black health and wellness. What is Black health and wellness, you may ask? Well, health is the body being physically free from diseases and illness. Wellness is the overall balance of the mind and body. As African Americans, it is imperative that we find places and spaces that are conducive to our well-being. We owe it to ourselves, our foremothers and forefathers, and our future generations to be well in our minds, well in our bodies, and well in our souls. This convocation is our space. It is our space to express our trials and triumphs. I hope that you all enjoy and take this event as a learning experience to better yourself and those that you love. Thank you.
Thank you, Ronnie, for that. And I think that it's so helpful that we put a spotlight on Black health and Black wellness. For eons, for centuries, we have had to carry the weight of the world on our shoulders and on our backs with little to no appreciation for that. And so when we have places where we are celebrated for the good things that we do, for the trials that we've been through, it's important that we take these moments as sacred. So time and time again, we put everyone ahead of ourselves. We make sure everyone is okay while we're crying at night. And so take this time, this program, this month, this day, to focus on self. And it does not make you selfish for that, because if we don't take care of ourselves, who will take care of us? It is important that we are strong in that we show brotherhood and sisterhood for our Black brothers and our Black sisters that are battling mental illnesses, physical illnesses, that we stay healthy in our minds, that we stay healthy in our bodies, that we stay healthy in our souls, so that we can be the best that we can be. Our ancestors did not fight for us to be laissez-faire or relaxed in our struggle or in our activism, but it is up to us to take up the charge, to take up the torch, to move forward and stay steadfast in what we are here to accomplish. So thank you. We'll have another musical selection by MVSU University Choir, If I Can Help Somebody. And I'm sorry, I also wanted to mention Mr. Brandon Cash. Thank you so much. Dr. Brandon Cash, I respect it. Dr. Brandon. give a round of applause. Next, we'll have introduction of the speaker by Ms. Narai Bond, the president of Epsilon Phi Chapter of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated.
Nestled in the piney woods of Hawkins, Texas. church, and I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge him. I have an appreciation for Mississippi Valley State University that began long before I started working here. My appreciation for Mississippi Valley State began when I was a little girl and I lived in Leland, Mississippi. And my parents and my older sister would come over to this very auditorium. And I would see beautiful black women being capped as nurses. I remember us driving from Leland to Grenada on Highway 82. And I remember seeing the signs changing from MBC to MBSC to MBSU. I have an affinity for Mississippi Valley State University because it is a place where many of my friends and family graduated. I have good memories here. I have made good friends here. And I would be remiss if I did not call the name of one who believed in me and one who loved Mississippi Valley State University, Mrs. Christine Williams. During this Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and Black History Convocation to proclaim that Black history is more than 1 month out of the year, that Black history is American history, that Black history is world history, and that it tells the brilliance, the beauty, and the boldness of those who are kissed by the sun and who have come over a way that tears have been watered, those who have come treading their hands the blood of the slaughtered. It is a history that cannot be legislated away or erased or whitewashed or diminished, and it cannot be done away with even in the face of ignorance about critical race theory. Black history is our history. It is real, it is relevant, and it reveals the tenacity of those who continue to contribute to the progress others, and we need Did you know that it was college students throughout the United States that made this country stand up and take notice of what was going on as it related to our sun-kissed sisters and brothers? College students in Tulu and Charlotte, and North Carolina and South Carolina and Jackson State and Clark and Southern University and Baton Rouge and MBSU and countless other schools who are muted in their day and said and did something about people are being hurt and we stay mute. God is not pleased when those of us who are called by his name turn our heads, when we see people are being mistreated and we stay mute. God is not pleased when he sees those who are created in his image being mistreated as if they are not created in his image because of the color of their skin and the texture of their hair and the broadness of their nose and the curvature of their hips. God is not pleased, and we cannot stay muted. We are expected to acute and say something. I'm mute and say something for heaven's sake, because we are told in Micah 6:8 to do justice, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with our God. I'm mute and say something for heaven's sake, because we are told in Isaiah 58:1 to cry aloud and do not hold back and lift up our voices. I'm mute and say something for heaven's sake, because we are told
Johnson was saying when they wrote the word.
what is now the Black or Negro National Anthem, the very words of the first verse is an imperative to unmute. Lift every voice and sing. Till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmony of liberty. Fire!
If I could have Dr. Briggs join me at the podium, I'm going to have a presentation.
All right, well, good afternoon. All right, I know we're going to do better than that. Good afternoon. This is a celebration, right? Absolutely. Let's give the choir and the band another round of applause. Matter of fact, let's give all of our students, will all of our students stand? All of our choir students stand. Our true, true Valley Scholars. Again, this is a celebration, and we're having a good time. We had an outstanding message, Dr. Pruitt. Let's give her another Valley round of applause. And if you could, Dr. Pruitt, if you'd join me here at the podium. On behalf of our university family, we thank you again for that powerful message. And we'd like to extend this token of our appreciation to you. And it reads, Mississippi Valley State University salutes Dr. Vanell M. Lee Pruitt, keynote speaker, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., Black History Month Annual Convocation, Black Health and Wellness, presented by Dr. Gerald Briggs, President, February 24, 2022. One goal, one team, one valley. In motion. Thank you. But I'd also, again, like to recognize if we have any alumni, any elected officials, community friends, foundation board members, and again, local and state officials, if y'all would please rise and be recognized. And thank you all again. For your continued support and love for Mississippi Valley State University. It is truly, truly a great day to be at the Valley. It really is. And also join me in just recognizing the Convocation Committee, the Department of Facilities Management, our MVSU ambassadors. Really, let's give our ambassadors a round of applause. And all that played a part in bringing this outstanding program here today. I think that we all can take something from what's been said here today and reflect on that, and reflect on our lives and our life experiences, and understand, as we're saying, the importance of Mississippi Valley State University, its past, its present, and its future. We will all be a part of that. We will all understand, again, the significance of what that means. So as we leave here today, let's make sure we say something or unmute ourselves. Let's make sure we speak to each other, we love each other, and we talk about the great things happening at our university. This is our community's university. This is our university. And we will assure its continued success. And I know we will do that because all of us here today have that same passion for that. Seeing this university prosper and grow. Because as our students are successful, and they truly are, we are successful as a university. So when we talk about those eight-word vision that I just said, and I'll say as I sit down, that one goal, one team, one valley, in motion, truly means more than just those words. And all of us together will assure we do what? We stay in motion. So again, thank you all for today. I think we're going to sing the alma mater, and we're going to appreciate and love Mississippi Valley State University. Thank you all.
present your gift.
We're doing the first verse and the chorus today. Thank you.